हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ सोनिया जॉन फ्रॉम बियानी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ साइंस एंड मैनेजमेंट फ्रॉम नर्सिंग डिपार्टमेंट. आई एम गोइंग टू टेक अ टॉपिक दैट इज टुडे आई एम डीलिंग विद डिहाइड्रेशन. डिहाइड्रेशन फर्स्ट वी मूव ऑन टू द डेफिनेशन. डिहाइड्रेशन मीन्स इट इज़ द एक्सेसिव लॉस ऑफ लिक्विड फ्रॉम द सेल्स एंड टिश्यूज ऑफ द बॉडी. ए पर्सन व्हेन ही इज डिहाइड्रेटेड और व्हेन हिज फ्लूइड इज लॉस्ट फ्रॉम द बॉडी, इट हैज़ बीन टर्म्ड एज डिहाइड्रेशन. And we know already know that the human body comprises of water. The male consists of 60% of water and the female consists of 50% of water. So when a person feeling of thirst, he drinks water, and when this act is not adequately attempted, then the person goes into dehydration. First we move on to the first we have seen the definition. Next causes. The first cause is inadequate intake of water. If the person is not taking sufficient amount of water, the person will not be dehydrated and he will be his cells and body cells and tissues will be lacking behind. Second is severe vomiting. If the person is having severe vomiting, that is person is losing the fluid in the form of vomiting, and the person will be having dehydration because of severe vomiting. Next we move severe diarrhea. If the person have severe diarrhea, that is passing loose stools for more than 5 to 6 times, he will be suffering from dehydration. Next cause is sunstroke. Sunstroke, we already know the radiations emitted by the suns takes away the fluid from our body, and that is also one of the causes for dehydration. Next is severe hemorrhage. If any injuries, any trauma which has been occurred in our body, because of that severe hemorrhage or severe bleeding will be there, and this causes dehydration. Next cause is diaphoresis. Diaphoresis is excessive sweating. When a person sweats excessively, it is known as diaphoresis, and he is having perspiration for a long time, and because of perspiration the person is losing his fluid from the body. Next is diabetes. Diabetes, the patient's sugar level will be increased, and in that the patient's will be suffering from, and its BP will be decreased. So the diabetic persons, they will be having more urine output. Because of that, because their output is more, this is also a cause for dehydration. Then cholera. Cholera, it includes both the in cholera also vomiting and diarrhea is present, and in both ways the person will be dehydrated, as the vomiting and diarrhea both will affect the person's fluid and electrolyte balance. Next we move on to the signs and symptoms. First, the person will have the sensation of thirst. The person, when he is dehydrated or when his lips will be dried, he feel that he have to drink water, and he will have the sensation of drinking water again and again. So the first sign is that the person will be feeling very thirsty. Second is dry mouth. When the fluid is lost from the body, the person's mouth will be dried. That is, there will be no water content or saliva will be dry. So because of that, we can be able to know that the person is dehydrated. Second is low skin integrity. Third is, in skin integrity, when the person is dehydrated, we can make out that the person's skin will be cracked, and the skin integrity will be very lost. So we can say the person is dehydrated. Then is cracked lips. When the person is dehydrated, because of loss of water, their lips will be cracked. Hypotension. We move on to the diagnostic evaluation. So diagnostic evaluation, we do history collection, physical examination, and thirdly we see according to the clinical manifestations. We have seen so many clinical manifestations, and according to that we do the diagnostic evaluation. Other than that, we do blood test. Blood test, we will see the serum electrolytes and blood urea nitrogen. When we assess blood urea nitrogen, we can see that the blood urea nitrogen level is increased in the assessment. Next we move on to the complications. First complication is confusion, that the person is confused. He is not getting, he is not oriented, he is not able to grasp, and he is not able to tell everything. And there will be confusion among what he wanted to do, everything can be confused type. So next is shock or coma. When the person is diabetic, when his high is hyperglycemia, and when the urine output is increased, so what happens? This person, when they is not getting adequate amount of water, and he is having a decreased amount of fluid, and the person when he is having increased amount of sugar, that what happens? The person may go into shock. When this condition is not treated, it can be fatal and it can lead to coma or hypovolemic shock. Next, we move on to the management. First, we move on to the medical management. Medical management, we can do it as in a two types. First, if there is mild dehydration, we'll give oral rehydration therapy. That is, we'll give the solution of ORS. And I'll teach you how ORS solution is made. It is made of four components, that is sodium chloride, sodium bicarbonate, potassium chloride and glucose. Sodium chloride we use 3.5 gram, sodium bicarbonate we use 2.5 gram and potassium chloride 1.5 gram and glucose 20 gram. This all contents are dissolved in 1000 ml of water or 1 liter of water. When the person is dehydrated, we make this solution and we treat it. And this is a oral preparation. This preparation is prepared and we can get it in the pharmacy. But we can prepare it at home also. For home, how we'll prepare is, that is, we will take 1 liter of water. In that, we'll put one spoon of sugar and one pinch of salt. And so it is mainly we have for more mild dehydration, we are giving oral rehydration therapy. Next, if severe dehydration is present, we'll administer IV fluids, that is to maintain the fluid and electrolyte, or to maintain the serum electrolytes, we are administering the IV fluids. If diarrhea is present, anti-diarrheal drugs. We know that as a part of diarrhea, the patient will be having dehydration. There will be excessive loss of fluid from the body of the patient. So for that, if diarrhea is present, we will administer him the anti-diarrheal drugs. Next, blood transfusion if hemorrhage occurs. If any injuries or hemorrhage is there, then we will assess the hemoglobin level. If the hemoglobin level is decreased, then blood transfusion, and if hemorrhage is also present, blood transfusion is done. Next, we move on to the nursing management. Nursing management, as the fluid and electrolyte balance is imbalanced, first we have to maintain the fluid and electrolyte balance. That is, we have to administer the IV fluids and we have to maintain the fluid and we have to give the patient orally by mouth also, so that the fluid level will be consistent in the person. Second, provide rest and comfort. We have to provide the person rest and sleep, and he should be kept in a comfortable position in order to prevent him from dehydration. Next, provide psychological support. As the fluid of the person is lost from the body, he is very lean, he may be very exhausted, so he will be having very anxiety about his disease. So for that, the nurse has to first provide the psychological support so that the person may become stable. And next point is maintain personal hygiene. We have to teach the person how to maintain the personal hygiene and the perineal and the anal, and he has to keep the anus clean and dry. And after each defecation, the patient should be given and he should be kept in a hygienic manner. Next, we see that the person's nutritional status should be maintained. As the person, if he is severely dehydrated, he won't be able to take from mouth. So we have to maintain the nutritional status of the patient through the IV fluids. And also, if the person is able to take by mouth, then we have to maintain the nutritional status and we have to give him the adequate amount of nutrition. Next, administer medications as per the physician's order. As the doctor has prescribed the medications for the person should be given medications time to time and it should not be avoided, and the person and the nurse should assess the condition of the patient and she should administer the medications as per the physician's order. Next, maintain the skin integrity. We know that when the person is dehydrated, his skin gets cracked and the integrity becomes low. So we have to maintain the skin integrity by applying some ointments, and also we have to give him fluids. And through maintaining the fluid and electrolyte balance, we can maintain the skin integrity of the patient. Next, we move on to the nursing diagnosis. Nursing diagnosis, the first diagnosis is that as the patient is having inadequate amount of fluid and electrolyte, so there will be fluid deficit related to diarrhea or vomiting or related to disease condition. Then second, there will be imbalanced nutritional status, less than body requirement, because he is not able to take an adequate amount of nutritional status. Then there will be low skin integrity. For that, there will be impaired skin integrity related to dehydration. Then fourth, anxiety related to disease condition. So this first we have seen the definition, then we have saw the causes. Next we move on to the signs and symptoms. Then we have seen the diagnostic evaluations, complications and management. Management, we have seen the severe minor dehydration as well as the severe dehydration. We have seen the medical management and the nursing management we have seen, and also the nursing diagnosis. Diarrhea, it is defined as the evacuation of the loose stools, that is the stools are loose and it consists of watery, so it is known as diarrhea. The causes are Helicobacter pylori, food poisoning, spicy food, contaminated food. Helicobacter pylori is the bacteria which affects our intestinal lining, and because of this bacteria, the person will tend to have diarrhea. Next is food poisoning. If the food we are taking, which is not good food, if it is a contaminated or it is a previous day food, or it may be having some bacteria, due to that food poisoning, the person may suffer from diarrhea. Then spicy food. When we take spicy food, some of the spices of this food will affect the lining of the stomach and intestines, and because of that, this is also a cause for diarrhea. Then contaminated food. If the food is not cooked properly, or if it is not covered properly, if the flies and other things have been seated on that and the person is having that same food, so because of that contamination of food, the person may also suffer from diarrhea. Next, we move on to the clinical features. First clinical feature is pain, that the patient will be having severe pain, that is he is having abdominal pain. Then he will be having discomfort. Then tenderness, that tenderness means pain on touching, and the patient will be having abdominal cramps, nausea, vomiting, that the person will be having a sensation of vomiting, and the patient will have an urgency to pass stool again and again. So these are the clinical features of diarrhea. Next we move on to the diagnostic evaluations. The diagnostic evaluations, first we will collect the history from the patient, that the patient is having what all type of food he has consumed, or due to which medicines he has occurred like this. Or then we'll do the physical examination. Then stool examination. Stool examination is done to assess which bacteria is present. To assess the bacteria, we are doing stool examination. Next we move on to the management. Management, I have already told in dehydration, the same as the management is also done for diarrhea. That is, first we'll do the oral rehydration therapy, that is to maintain the fluid and electrolyte which has been lost from the body because of loose stools. So we first will give the oral rehydration therapy to prevent the dehydration. So for that we'll give ORS. Then ORS is prepared. I have already told the composition of ORS, that is there will be sodium chloride, sodium bicarbonate, potassium chloride and glucose, and these all contents will be dissolved in 1000 ml of water or 1 liter of water. Next, as the person may be having the diarrhea may be because of the bacteria, so to avoid all the inflammation, we will give the antibiotics. Then analgesics should be administered to relieve the pain of the patient. And if the patient is having excessive diarrhea, because of that we are administering anti-diarrheal drugs. So these are the medical management which we are giving for the patient with diarrhea. And for nursing management, the nursing management include, first we will administer the IV fluids to maintain the fluid and electrolyte balance. Second, we have to maintain the hygiene of the patient. Then the spicy food should be avoided. No caffeine and nothing should be given in the diet. Smoking should be avoided, and also the patient should be avoided the spicy food and also the contaminated food. The person should have the fresh prepared food, and the patient should get a small and light diet, so that it will be and the diet should be given frequently in order to protect the person from dehydration. So these are the steps how we can prevent the person from diarrhea and from getting a person to be dehydrated from a state of diarrhea. Thank you, thank you, and thank you.